upper airway obstruction. In this module, you will learn to recognize upper airway obstruction. The first objective is to review the signs of upper airway obstruction in children. The second objective is to differentiate stridor from other signs of upper airway obstruction. The third objective is to recognize that a child has stridor based on a physical exam. Let's review a few definitions. Upper airway obstruction happens when there is difficulty or resistance when air is moving through the windpipe into the lungs. This is caused by fluid or secretions, a physical object, the tongue, or swelling, which causes a partial or complete obstruction. Upper airway obstruction can occur anywhere from the tip of the lips or nose through the windpipe, lower airways, and lungs. Signs of upper airway obstruction include retractions, in which the skin over the chest pulls in between the ribs when a child has difficulty breathing. Stridor, which is an abnormal, high-pitched sound that is commonly caused by disrupted airflow. And stertor, which is a low-pitched, noisy breathing sound that mimics snoring. Additional signs of upper airway obstruction include snoring, drooling, tripoding, or fainting. Upper airway obstruction leads to respiratory arrest and ultimately death. This is why it is so important to recognize signs of upper airway obstruction and when and how to intervene. Now let's focus on one of the signs of upper airway obstruction, stridor. Stridor can occur during inspiration, breathing in, exhalation, breathing out, or both during inspiration and exhalation. Where the narrowing or obstruction in the airway occurs determines if the stridor is heard when breathing in, breathing out, or both. Stridor that occurs during inspiration indicates that there is an obstruction or narrowing either above the vocal cords or immediately below the vocal cords. Stridor can be caused by croup, bacterial tracheitis, epiglottitis, or a foreign body. Stridor is common and can be a medical emergency. A child's airway is more narrow and floppy than an adult's airway, which is why disruptions in airflow and stridor are more problematic in children than adults. Stridor can be mild, moderate, or severe. Mild stridor is heard only with crying or agitation, and it suggests some swelling or blockage in the airway. Moderate to severe stridor is heard both with agitation and, importantly, while at rest, and it suggests significant swelling or obstruction in the airway. Severe retractions, even when stridor is mild, are a sign of significant airway obstruction. Sometimes the stridor gets quieter and retractions get worse when kids tire out or the obstruction is severe. This should be seen as a sign of severe obstruction, and urgent evaluation and treatment are required. Now, let's listen to what stridor sounds like. Notice here that the patient is experiencing stridor with subcostal retractions. Notice here that the patient is experiencing stridor with suprasternal retractions. Notice here that the patient is experiencing stridor with subcostal retractions, intercostal retractions, suprasternal retractions, and head bobbing. The main takeaways are: upper airway obstruction is caused by blockages above the glottis. Obstruction can be caused by the tongue due to secretions, due to poor muscle tone, or by airway edema, or swelling. airway obstruction can be an emergency and deserves immediate medical attention. Additionally, stridor, a common sign of pediatric upper airway obstruction, is a high-pitched sound that occurs during inspiration. Moderate to severe stridor is heard at rest, can be life-threatening, and is a medical emergency.